Hello all, welcome to this interesting and very useful topic of flat file systems in DBMS. I hope you have gone through the previous tutorials and start making the notes also. Let us proceed. So in the previous video, what I have asked that what was the need of database, or in other words, have you ever thought that in earlier times, what type of method was used by developers to store their data? And I have also requested you to kindly see the history of, you know, computers, that is ENIAC, UNIVOC. You can see some videos also. They are very interesting. Anyways, I hope that you have done this. Let us move ahead. So in earlier days of programming, what was there? There was languages like COBOL, Pascal, Fortran. Even the Infosys first project was in similar type of languages. Narayan Murthy and their friends, they decided to set up a company. They took a project and they wrote thousands of lines of code, which was successful. And rest is history, you know about Infosys. So some of you must be looking forward to get selected in Infosys only. So let us see yesterday's diagram. What we have seen that there are different approaches to data management. Like we have seen that, let us make it a little bit bigger. So if you see, there was manual, electronic, and we are interested in computer. So as I've told you, we will be focusing more on DBMS, but let us have an intro of these. See, office automation packages, you can maintain your data. Okay, for example, let us see. Excel. In Excel, you have maintained the name and date of birth of your friends. Okay, A, B, C, D, something, date of birth, anything, something, something, something like this. So this is also your database, but it is not DBMS. Okay, please be very clear. So what is the advantage of this? The advantage is you need not to do any type of coding. You just keep your data. You can arrange it. You can sort it. You can sort it according to different type of method. For example, you can sort according to date of birth. Okay. You can sort according to name. You can have a graph. You can have a chart and so on. But these things have a limitation. What limitation? The first thing is that as soon as the data becomes too large, these sheets become heavy and everything is visible in front of you. And there is no data security. For example, if suddenly I change something here, look here, and I don't remember that what I have changed, and I save the file and come back, close the file and come back. Okay. So when I will press undo, it will not happen. Just have a look. See, I have done, let me save it with something like name. Let me close it. Let me come back. So what you can see, 56, if I will undo, it will not be changed. And I cannot know that which number I have changed. So moreover, you cannot fire queries, complicated query on these type of data. So this method has certain limitation. However, in earlier times, you must not be knowing, but I must tell you that around 30 years back, there was a popular software called as Lotus and WordStar. Even I have worked on them. These were the earlier versions of MS Excel and MS Word. They again change the business a lot because people don't have to program and they can maintain their data. But still it has number of limitations. So now we will not focus more on this. Now we will come to this. So in 1970s, 80s, 90s, the main method of storage of data was use of flat file system. Now what is flat file system? Flat file system is also known as traditional file oriented system. Okay. You can call it as TFOS, that is traditional file oriented system or flat files. Okay. So now what are these flat files? See, as you know, you have seen and I have told you that computers are being used for more than 70 years. So at that time, there was no Oracle, no DBMS, no networking, but data was stored. And data was stored on tape drives. So what type of method was used? The only method that time available was flat files. So what is flat file? Which you very well know with the name of file handling. Okay, so file handling was the only method at that time available to store the data. Okay, you must be remembering now, you must have done file handling in C, C++. You must have created some file using file pointer, fopen, fread, fwrite, fp, something like this. Okay, so these applications were called as one-tier application. So what is a one-tier application? One-tier application mean in which front-end and back-end both are same. C or COBOL was the front-end and C and COBOL is the back-end only. Back-end means the data is stored using the same file handling technique of this language only. So around 30-40 years, this was the only way the users can store data. Okay. However, with the time, in 1970s, the things changed and two-tier applications came. So what were two-tier application? A two-tier application was having at least a front-end separate and a back-end. Front-end means the interface that you see and back-end means the DBMS. We will come back to this for the entire syllabus, but right now we are a little bit focusing on front-end or flat files, one-tier. So let us see an example of it, then we move ahead. Okay. Let me show you an example of now. See, this is what a typical computer software looks like. Okay, in future or maybe in some semester you might have to make this type of software also. Now you can see what is this? This is user interface. Okay, what user can see? User can very easily navigate, add. Suppose if I want to add some record, I will go in the last and I will add some record. Okay, suppose I have added first name Amit or maybe Rohit. Okay, last name maybe Sharma. Okay, title maybe Mr. Reports to, let us take a value, or reports to the higher date, leave it, extension, something. And I will save it. So very simple. So this is what is user interface or front end is. Okay. So now this can be made in, for example, this might be developed in Java, .NET, PHP, Python, or any other technology. There are thousands of technologies. However, this data is coming from backend. Let me show you that backend. See, if you go through, see, there are a number of tables. We will come back to the topic of table later on, but right now. So what you can see is that, now see what I have written just now, Sharma, Rohit, Mr. This is here. Okay. And whatever data you are seeing is coming from this table only, as you can see. And if you make any changes here, it will, for example, if I change their name to, suppose I, let us do it Kanika. See, right now the name is this and here it is Kanika, but as soon as it will change, you can see the name has changed to Kanika. So this table is your backend and this is your front end. So this is a typical software that you will, that you can see everywhere around you, maybe in supermarket, maybe in Domino's, Pizza Hut, everywhere you will see similar type of software. Of course, there are some other intermediate technologies also, but it can be N tier, 2 tier, 3 tier, 4 tier, but at least 2 tier technologies are there. So this is the modern example. But in earlier times, this was not the case. There was no Windows, there was no colorful interface, there was no DBMS, there was no table. So, but the programmer had to develop the programs. So it was a little bit difficult. So let us see an example. What was that? Flat files. So flat files.